Following the excellence of version 8, ActivePresenter 9 has been released with nearly 20 new features and enhancements that will simplify your editing experience. I'm Clay, and let's accompany with me till the end of today's video to know what's new in ActivePresenter 9. The first new feature is Table. Tables make it easy to store and organize data in rows and columns. So, you can find the table command from the Insert tab, then access the table's styles group in the Table's Tools tab or Properties pane to quickly format your data, and make changes to the style options and other settings to achieve your wish. The next new feature is Chart, which is an effective way to visualize text and data-heavy content. Okay, so this version offers you up to 10 chart types and variations to name a few as columns, lines, bars, pines, and donuts. And if you prefer another type after creating your chart, don't worry, since you can switch between different chart types in ActivePresenter 9. While charts and tables only allow you to organize and compare data, 3D models will be the one who helps you create a real-world environment for your projects. So, the app lets you insert mainstream 3D file formats, as well as add 3D models from PowerPoint via the Import PowerPoint feature, and thus visualize scenes that are hard to imagine, or bringing lively three-dimensional objects to your project is now like a piece of cake. And slider is a brand new interactive object in ActivePresenter 9. So a slider consists of a thumb that users will move between the minimum and the maximum values of a track. And each time you move the thumb, the slider updates its values. And thus, you can use sliders to display stages in a timeline or change settings such as volume or speed. Okay, so now let's move on to the next feature. If you have a long list of content to show in menus, dropdowns are here to help. So a dropdown can save screen space, which makes the projects look well arranged. And in a dropdown, a hint item shows at first. Clicking it will reveal a list of options for learners to interact with at their convenience. And dropdowns can be used as command menus, form fillings, navigation menus, attribute selections, and so on. Okay, so in the previous versions, ActivePresenter has offered you 11 convenient ready-made question types for your quiz. And in this new version, two more types of dropdown questions are supported, which are Select in Dropdown and Select in Dropdowns. A Select in Dropdown question contains a dropdown with a hidden list of options that allows learners to select from it, and the dropdown menu is shown once learners click on the dropdown arrow. Each Select in Dropdown question has only one dropdown, and so you cannot remove it or add more. Meanwhile, Select in Dropdowns question allows you to create a question having more than one dropdown, and you are free to add more or remove the four default dropdowns as you wish, and you have to set the correct answers for each dropdown separately. Okay, so let's move on to the next new feature, Click Sequence Timeline. A timeline defines how multiple objects in a slide show or hide against time. And by default, each slide has a main timeline which runs automatically when a slide is loaded. So ActivePresenter 9 allows you to create a click sequence timeline as well as many other interactive timelines. And these timelines perform specific tasks and can only be executed by events and actions. In the click sequence timeline, you can choose to start an animation when clicking the mouse, or coordinate it with other effects on a slide by using Start on Click or start with previous. Okay, one question for you. Have you already been an active presenter user? Then the canvas snapping feature might not sound strange to you. From version 9, this feature is integrated with grid and guides with more options for you to quickly and perfectly align objects on the canvas. Smart guides are default orange lines available only when you drag or reshape objects. And besides smart guides, you can also enable grid lines and guides by accessing the View tab. Okay, that's the new features that ActivePresenter 9 brings back to you. What about the enhancements for the ready-made features? Let's take a quick look at them. The first enhancement. You can now preview and export selected slides. You can choose one out of four operation modes here to preview your current slide, not the whole one. And with ActivePresenter 9, exporting one or multiple selected slides to a video is at your fingertips by right-clicking them and selecting Save Slide as Video or Save Selected Slides as Video. Next, you now have 30 slide transitions and 80 animation effects to choose from. Support cropping images and videos. You can now crop images and videos right on canvas. Display video frames on the timeline and support frame snapping. Allow rotating and flipping objects vertically or horizontally. Enhance import questions from CSV files. Add more question types like sequence, essay, fill in text entries, rating scale, select in dropdown, and select in dropdowns. Export to video feature. Add audio and video quality, as well as bitrate options. Add more events and actions. Add the opacity effect for objects. And many other improvements you can read later in the written tutorial. So, are you ready to explore the new version of ActivePresenter 9? Let's download ActivePresenter 9 from the link in the description box below and like, share, and comment your opinions about this version. And more videos about the new features of ActivePresenter 9 will be published soon. So, stay tuned. And now, goodbye.